So it's been a week now. Here's the rim that my wife hit. Relatively small, but still pretty noticeable from up close and also kind of far away. And I unfortunately also hit a curb as well. So mine was much worse. But I'm going to try and repair these. I'll show you the process and what I did. I recently did another video on things I like about the Model Y, and one was just these low profile tires with the induction rims, just the look of them. But the clearance to ground is really small. You can see 2.5 inches and you can look at it from the side. There's just not a lot of clearance, which is what causes this rim rash to begin with, or curb rash to begin with. And if we just put it next to a traditional Equinox tire, you can see there's much more clearance there. So what happens if you do get some curb rash? Well, here's how you would, here's the things you would first need to fix it. So there's really three things that you're going to need here. One, well, actually maybe four. One is just a general masking tape, which you'll see that I'll put on the rim. The tape that you see here in the image is a 3M with blue lock, what they're calling blue edge lock. This is the tape that I found that really sticks well to the actual tire itself. And then I just use a general masking tape for the traditional painter's tape for the actual rims. You'll need some type of sandpaper. I went with a 3M Sandblaster Pro Edge Detailing 80 grit. You could probably do something higher that's maybe a little bit smoother, like 100 grit or 120. I just didn't want to be sanding all day long, so I went with something with a little bit more grit to it and a little bit sharper finish. And the third thing is the paint to paint over the rim. The Rust-Oleum High Performance Wheel is the paint that I found that matches. And I'll talk about that a little bit more in a second. But all this stuff you can get online or at Home Depot. I'll put a link in the description so you can pick it up if you need to. And I would say the paint was around $8, maybe $8, $9. Sand sponge was about $4, and the tape was also about $4. So relatively inexpensive. So when you look at Rust-Oleum at the home improvement store and online, you may see two different ones that look very similar. From the caps, they look almost identical. The one on the left is a matte finish, which does not match the 20-inch rims that are on the Tesla Model Y. The one on the right is a high-performance wheel, also matte, but that one does match perfectly. And I'll put the link to the correct Rust-Oleum in the description. So I'm going to start with the driver's side rear rim, and we'll just take some painter's tape here and put it over the general part of the rim. And the idea here is that I'm going to be sanding this area, and I just don't want to scuff or scratch any part that I don't have to in the process. Okay, so once I have this kind of the area that I want to sand, I'm just going to start sanding it down so that it can be a much smoother surface. Now, I will say this is kind of the point of no return here. Once I started sanding, I realized how different the rim looks once you start sanding. So there was some initial panic that set in that maybe I wasn't going to be able to do this, or maybe I'm going to have to bring this to a rim shop after this and they're going to see how bad of a job I did, but it ended up turning out okay in the end. You can be the judge here at the final reveal, but there will be some initial kind of shock setting in here when you start to sand the rim. And so then here we put the blue lock tape on the tire, because that will actually stick. The regular painter's tape just would not stick. This blue lock sticks really well to the tire. Depending on the surface that you're going to be spraying on and where the orientation of the tire, you may want to just put something underneath your tire so that any spray doesn't get on the ground. And then I didn't know the color, if it would match, so I put some extra paper kind of over the rest of the rim just in case any of the spray got over that far. Now that I know the color, it matches exactly. I don't know that I would necessarily need to have the newspaper there. Here's a similar process on the passenger side, And this one was much worse, so this took a lot more sanding. But once you get it to that level, then you can kind of just apply this paint in an even stroke and then let it dry for about 10 minutes and then reapply again. So this is a gradual process that takes several steps. So here's the finished driver's side wheel from far away. And it's hard to really see where that blemish was. I will zoom in here in a second so you can see it. And you can see there, then it probably could have sanded this better, and I probably will go back and resand it. But from far away, it's good enough that you really just don't see the blemish. And I'll switch here to the other side. This is the passenger side here. Same thing, can't see it from far away. This one was much worse, but I think I did a better job sanding this one. You'll see it here on the zoom in. So a little bit more flush. And it's really hard to tell from if you're standing a couple feet away. So hopefully this helps. Thanks.